Do you sometimes feel the need for speed? Does the sight of a shiny new automobile ka-chow! Make you a little lightheaded? Did you ever give your car a name because you thought it had a personality all its own?
There's a lot of love out there, you know, man.
Don't embarrass me, Fillmore.
Hi, I'm John Ratzenberger. And if you answered yes to any of those questions, you're probably going to want to park it right there in front of the TV, because we're about to give you an exclusive look at the Disney presentation of a Pixar film, Cars Under the Hood. So, buckle up, because you're in for the ride of your life. Yeah! A cross-country adventure that is filled with action.
California, here I come!
Imagination.
Holy Porsche.
And the unforgettable characters.
Morning, sleeping beauty.
Drivers, start your engines. Now, when you think of the creators of the all-time great automobiles, a lot of names come to mind. You know, Chevy Corvette, Ford Mustang, Ferrari, Porsche. But when you think of the creators of the biggest string of all-time great animated films, there's really only two names, Disney and Pixar.
Hello?
Oh, yeah.
In Toy Story, audiences got a look inside the secret world of toys. A Bug's Life was an epic story of miniature proportions. Monsters, Inc. took us to an incredible world just beyond our closet doors. In Finding Nemo, we plunged beneath the waves. And in The Incredibles, we saw behind the masks of a family of superheroes.
There's no way the rookie can make it through.
In Cars, the wizards at Pixar have once again taken us on a thrilling journey to a never-before-seen world. Imagine a place populated entirely by cars, trucks, and magnificent machinery. Now, imagine a place where all those machines can talk.
If anybody asked you, we was out smashing mailboxes, okay?
And perhaps most amazing of all, imagine a place where fuel is cheap and plentiful.
Whoa! What do you have at your store?
I have gas. Lots of gas.
But those are just a few of the wonders that lie in store for you when you enter the wonderful world of cars.
Look at me! Here I am!
Love me.
In this world where cars are alive and there are no humans, race cars are like athletes. And Lightning McQueen has become a superstar.
Lightning is somebody who just wants to kind of go fast and win. He doesn't really care about much else beyond winning and the glory that comes with that.
What he dreams of is the fame, the fortune, the girls.
We're like your biggest fans! Ka-chow!
Love me.
All of the success has gone to his head in the wrong way.
Chuck, what are you doing? You're blocking the camera. Everyone wants to see the bolt.
What?
Now back away.
On his way to the last race of the season.
The interstate.
Lightning gets lost in an old Route 66 town that the interstate has bypassed years ago.
Not in my town, you don't.
No one comes to this town anymore.
No! Stop!
It's inhabited by nothing but old cars from the 50s and 60s.
Whoa, no!
And they have no idea who he is. He's arrested, and he gets stuck in the town of Radiator Springs.
All right, I want to know who's responsible for wrecking my town, Sheriff. I'm going to put him in jail till he rots.
Come on, make this guy fix the road. The town needs this.
He sentenced a community service to fix the road that he wrecked as he went through town.
Oh, man, that's just great.
Hey, what's wrong?
My lucky sticker's all dirty.
Ah, that ain't nothing. I'll clean it for you.
That won't be necessary.
He thinks he's in the worst place possible.
I'm in hillbilly hell! My IQ's dropping by the second! I'm becoming one of them!
While he's there, though, all these old cars that he didn't like from the beginning start changing him.
He goes to that town, and all the small things that he thinks are stupid, they actually have a meaning.
I fell in love with this.
He begins to kind of appreciate some of the values and some of the things that this small town has to offer.
Whoa.
T-
taking time to find yourself and slow down and enjoy life.
When is the last time you cared about something except yourself, Hot Rod?
He starts recognizing what's missing in his life.
These are good folk around here who care about one another. I don't want them depending on someone they can't count on.
He realizes that his life is not about all the championships you win. It's about the family and friends that you have around you to celebrate the successes. Woo-hoo!
Dadgum! Boy, I tell you what, son, I drive my tires over a mile of busted glass just to see that picture right there.
Now it's time to really do what the title of this show promises. Take you for a look under the hood to see what, or should I say who, makes these babies purr.
I create feelings in others that they themselves don't understand. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I scare you?
Owen has this amazing way of wording things that is so unique to him and so charming.
You know, I'm going to treasure every word of that. I really am.
And we've never had an actor work harder to get it right.
You kind of get to a session, you're like, wow, we're going to say ka-chow again.
Ka-chow!
Didn't we get that last time?
Ka-chow! Ka-chow!
I want you to do that again. That was great.
We're doing something slightly different. Ka-chow! Ka-chow!
Gosh, I said that so many times.
Owen has this amazing way to take a character that at times may not be so likable, but he makes him so appealing.
Listen, I'm going to cut to the chase. Me, you, dinner.
What the? Ow! Ooh, please! Ah.
I'll let you know, I probably am the best one in it.
Bonnie is one of the best ad-libbers to ever work in the business.
Figured that all out on your own, did you?
Should have good ideas and ways to kind of improve the script.
And I just think she's cute as a button, too.
John, he always told me I was built like a Buick.
Holy Porsche.
I turned out to be a Porsche in this. Felt flattered.
Doc, you look great this morning. Did you do something different with your side view mirrors?
What do you want, Sally?
In choosing the voice for Doc Hudson, we always wanted to have Paul Newman.
Yeah, right. I just knew it was Pixar, it was Lasseter, it was about racing. I said the combination is irresistible.
He's synonymous as car racing.
It's so different from making a film. You don't bring anything except your voice. Change the dialogue a little bit.
We'll do it straight a couple of times.
Try it 15 different ways.
Yeah. And then go back and screw it up.
Okay.
There was simply no price that you had to pay for being foolish.
Ow, 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 ow.
No.
Hey, you drive like you fix roads. Lousy. Have fun fishing, Mater.
We found probably the greatest American actor living today.
Gee, no, you kidding me?
Larry the Cable Guy.
Come on, Karen, what do you think now? Come on, get over there now, what do you think now, Harry?
Talk about someone who brought a few things to the part.
I just knowed it. I wasn't tractor tipping.
Well, if you think that's great, you should see the rest of this town.
Very good. That was 12 calories.
It just was a crack up in every one of our sessions.
When I'd say a line and he'd start laughing, I knew he was doing pretty good.
Anybody ask you, we was out smashing mailboxes, okay?
That's great.
I needed a...
Show off.
I've always loved the work of Tony Shalhoub.
Oh, è bellissima.
He acted from the tips of his toes.
Lightning! There you are!
All the way up to the ends of his fingers.
It's like it was paved by angels.
When you see Luigi get on his tires, get all excited.
I can't believe it.
That comes from Tony Shalhoub.
Oh, you feel that? Feel that? Oh.
When we're looking at the 1959 Chevy Impala Lowrider, there's only one name that came to mind.
Oh, yeah, baby. Lemon Yellow, kiss a fellow.
We did a session together, Cheech and I.
This guy is, he's a romantic.
Poker up.
He's funny.
So I always encourage the actors to make it their own, to find that something that is unique to them. And I tell you,
oh, yeah.
They all just hit it out of the park.
Ooh, Ramon?
Mama ain't seen you that low in years.
Now that you've met some of the stars who use their voices to bring these machines to life, let's take an even closer look at some of the nuts and bolts from the car's assembly line. Well, mostly nuts.
Be careful. Folks around here are not firing on all cylinders, if you know what I mean.
I mean, what makes it fun is for me working with the Pixar people.
My name's Mater. Like, Tomater, but without the tuh.
So they let the lunatics run the asylum.
There are people riding around in the lobby on skateboards.
Ping pong tables.
There's basketball courts and tennis rackets.
Foosball.
In that environment, those creative types really flourish.
Their imaginations are the gold mine of their storytelling process.
I don't believe what I'm watching, Bob!
One of the things that was really important for us in making this world believable was the idea that there were no humans in this world.
They're all cars. Everything is cars.
Show us the proof! I'm confused.
I thought there'd at least be people in the bleachers.
Get your antenna balls here!
We needed to think about, okay, if cars were alive and there were no humans, they would have buildings, but basically they're garages. Like a restaurant to us is like a gas station to cars. So the town diner looks like a 50s drive-in restaurant, but it's a gas station.
How about something to drink? Stop at Flo's V8 Cafe. Finest fuel on Route 66.
No, we just topped off.
Catty corner to it is Luigi's Tire Shop.
Home of the Leaning Tower of Tires.
And is this also part of my interior?
Yes.
When you go inside, you know what it looks like? A men's shoe store. And he only sells Italian tires.
White the wall of tires.
The paint shop.
Ramon will paint you up right. Hey, anything you want.
Where Ramon, the 59 Chevy Impala lowrider, works. It's kind of like a little tattoo parlor, you know.
Ka-chow.
We really worked hard.
Oh, yeah.
Woo! To figure out how this world works. There we go. To make this world believable.
You do start questioning all sorts of, how are they born? Are there children cars? Where do cars come from? How do cars do anything? Like while he's reading a book, can we have a car do that?
We'd be sitting there in the story rooms and we were saying, McQueen will pick up a map and unfold it. And we're like, oh yeah, you can't do that, you know?
I don't need a map, I have the GPS. Never need a map again, thank you.
So we had to think through, what would be the rules in this world?
Many, many, many people through the years have brought cars to life in animation or in live action, and the headlights have always been the eyes.
Well, you know, race cars don't need headlights because the track is always lit.
Yeah, well, so's my brother, but he still needs headlights.
Now, what Walt Disney and his animators did with one of my favorite Disney cartoons in Susie the Little Blue Coupe is that they put the eyes in the windshield. And so we were very inspired by that, because what that does is now changes the whole where the face of the car is. Now it's like the windshield is the eyes, and the hood becomes the nose, and the mouth is down here, and all of a sudden the entire car becomes the head.
I knew it. I knowed I made a good choice.
In what?
My best friend.
And the eyes become the window to the soul of the character. It's where the acting comes from, where the thinking of the acting comes from, of the character.
What? You need tires, you idiot!
Now, the four tires are neatly placed symmetrically kind of under the body, and so it becomes like a four-legged character. And it gives so much more opportunity as an animator to bring life to the character.
One of the things that I was very aware of in this film is how intricate and expert the animation process has become, so that very, very soon it will duplicate photography.
It's actual stuff. I mean, the way those cars passed each other, the way they spin, the way the announcers get excited.
I think kids are gonna be just mesmerized.
She just likes me for my body.
It's breathtaking.
Yes!
But also, I think that they'll be very impressed with the heart and soul of all the characters.
This is the most glorious day of my life.
Hey, thanks for hitting the road with us for this special test drive of Cars. But remember, What you've just seen is only a few miles of a cross-country adventure that is filled with fasten your seatbelt action. Plenty of humor under the hood.
That's funny.
A trunkload of heart.
Wait, you're being nice to me.
Nah.
Enjoy the ride.